The next reaction of carboxylic acids is the reaction with diazomethane. Pretty simple reaction. When you take diazomethane, that is CH2N2, in the presence of heat, it results in the formation of an ester. So when I write the resonating structure of diazomethane, there is negative charge on the carbon atom, positive charge on nitrogen. The negative charge, it's like a base, it abstracts the hydrogen. So you are getting C double bond O minus. Carboxylic acid gives a H plus, simply to put. So this is the carboxylate group and CH3N, triple bond N. So when this group reacts with the carboxylate anion, so O minus and CH3, it forms OCH3, and nitrogen, since it's a good leaving group. So when nitrogen leaves, what happens? Positive charge, it attacks with the negative charge. So R C double bond O CH3, that is what I've written here. Nitrogen gets eliminated out. That's the driving force for the reaction. That's the reaction. The next reaction is Schmidt reaction. It is carboxylic acid plus HN3, hydrozoic acid, in the presence of an acid. So carboxylic acid forms amine plus CO2 plus N2. So in this reaction, the carboxylic acid is made to react with the acid. So again, the double bond OH plus attacks there. Two OH groups, which results in the formation of a positive charge on the carbon. So in the HN3, so H plus is required because we need to initiate the reaction. So in the process of the reaction, positive charge is there on this carbon atom. So the negative charge in the resonating structure of HN3. So we can write resonating structure of HN3 or CH2N2 with negative charge on nitrogen and positive charge on the carbon. So the negative charge attacks on the positive charge of the carbon atom. This is the resultant structure. From this, we can eliminate out an OH and H plus. Okay, so what I'm doing is two OH groups that are present, OH and a H plus, which results in the formation of C double bond O NH and triple bond, and the remaining part of the structure is as it is. And you know, always the nitrogen tends to get eliminated because a gas is being released. So nitrogen gets eliminated in the process, which results in the positive charge on the nitrogen atom. So positive charge on nitrogen is not very stable. So this we'll call it electron deficient nitrogen. So immediately, so the moment the positive charge is there on the nitrogen atom, an alkyl shift takes place. So this alkyl group shifts onto the nitrogen atom, which results in the formation of R on the nitrogen atom and a positive charge on the carbon. And further, what happens is, when you take out the H plus that is present over here, so what you are getting is, this bond shifts in this direction to nullify the positive charge. That is, when you remove out the H plus, this bond shifts in this direction. So you are getting R N. This bond shifted here, so it's a double bond and a C double bond O. It is RN double bond C double bond O. So this group is called isocyanate group, so which on hydrolysis will form H2O. So very important thing in this reaction is electron deficient nitrogen is present during the process. The moment that is present, immediately an alkyl shift takes place. We'll see many reactions of this type. In the Schmidt reaction also, electron deficient nitrogen is there, immediately an alkyl shift takes place, isocyanate formation. The moment isocyanate is formed, it results in the formation on hydrolysis, it will give NH2. Pretty simple thing what to do. When you do hydrolysis, add H and OH. That is, one bond will break. Again, when you do hydrolysis, add one more H and one more OH. The second bond will break. Two OH not stable on it, so they'll form a double bond O. So this part becomes the CO2 group. Two hydrogens. After breaking two bonds, you're adding two hydrogens. That part becomes the NH2 group. That is Schmidt reaction.